This is what the priests work here. The priests come to the byway, highways and the byways, and they teach the word of God.
Are you celibate?
Why can this be our job?
Are you celibate?
Why can this not be our job?
Are you celibate?
Absolutely, I'm a priest.
Are you celibate?
I am a priest.
Are you celibate?
What is it being celibate?
Do you practice celibacy? Does the scripture tell you to practice celibacy?
What scripture are you
What do you do for a living, bro?
What scripture are you
Where do you work? You're racist, bro. Y'all are racist, bro.
Can I ask you a question?
Y'all are racist.
No, what's racist is 400 years of slavery.
I agree, bro.
What's racist is with the Trail of Tears.
I agree.
What's racist is the fact that wounded me. What's racist is the government of America and their police force murdering blacks.
Amen.
They're racist. What does that mean?
They hate the Jews. They hate white people.
They're saying that they are Jews.
Yeah, well, they're wrong. You know that.
See, I don't know anything.
This sinful kingdom has been influencing blacks and Hispanics and Native Americans to follow after that same beast that we talked about in the days of the Roman Empire. The Roman Empire is the fourth beast, and that is where this image comes from. Give me this one more time, Bob. Shut up. Why does it matter that what this man actually looks like? But I gotta tell you something. It's because the Bible says Christ is black that we gotta put this image down forever.
That's right.
Because that's the image of the beast.
Right.
That's the lie that has kept our people clinging to a sinful kingdom. Read that again.
What kind of Israelite are you?
The bloodline Israelites from the Bible, the ancient Hebrew Israelites.
Which one?
You got a question about what kind of Israelites are we?
Yeah.
Universal practical knowledge.
Okay.
Established in 1969. I ask you, how do you feel about what
you don't know who my people are?
You just say you're a Gentile.
Yeah, there's a lot of different Gentiles.
I didn't label you. So just tell me
who you are, and then I'll listen
nations,
to you.
The Bible says all the nations are confederate against us. So what type of, it doesn't matter what type of Gentile you are. All the nations
confederate. All right, all right. So this
they
is
all it. Are confederate. Hold on, slow down.
This is an interesting
slow
question.
Down. Slow down,
interesting
swiftly.
Question.
Swiftly. Slow down.
It's an interesting question.
The Bible says they are all confederate against us.
Okay.
So you cannot swiggle out of this.
I'm not swiggling out of anything.
If you're non-Israelite.
This is an interesting question.
If you're non-Israelite. I'm going to let you speak. Go ahead.
Do you think the Messiah has come?
No, yes, he's come once before.
Okay. That's a big step.
Mm-hmm.
So are you saying it's not possible to be grafted into the tree of salvation?
No, you cannot be grafted into the tree of salvation.
Okay.
Because what makes you an Israelite is the lineage that you're born of.
Well, that's not what I'm talking about.
Well, being grafted in, how can you be grafted in?
Through Christ.
No, why? Through how?
Through Christ, the Messiah. That's what he does.
No,
he saves all people.
Do you know what makes a man an Israelite?
I'm not. It's irrelevant once Christ has come.
No, it's not irrelevant.
Yes, it is.
How? So what are you proving to say that?
Through Christ.
How? So you're saying that Gentiles are going to be saved, is what you're saying?
Yeah, through Christ.
But do you know who
That's what Paul says?
I know. But I know. You don't understand the Bible. That's why.
I don't.
You don't understand the Bible. Gentiles in the Bible usually means non-Israelite.
Not always.
Right. Usually means
not
non-Israelite.
Always.
But it also means an Israelite who is following the customs of the heathens. That's what the Gentiles that you're speaking
sometimes
about being saved.
Not always.
But when it talks about salvation for the Gentiles, those are the times that it's talking about Israelites who are taking on the customs of Gentiles, of heathens. So when you're talking about being saved for Gentiles, it's still talking about Israelites. Not any man that's on the earth who believes in Christ. That's not what it's about.
Why?
I just told you why. Because Christ said...
You didn't tell me anything.
Give me Matthew 15:24. I'm going to show you right now. I mean, it's all throughout the Bible. I mean, Paul learned from Christ, didn't he?
In front of their cameras, they hate you.
Did Paul learn from Christ? I'm asking you a question. You don't want to answer that question because you know
that... Did Paul meet Christ?
Did Paul learn from Christ?
That's a different question.
But did Paul learn from... Who was Paul teaching? The teachings of Christ?
Yeah.
Okay, so what did Christ say?
The conversion of Paul.
This is the book of Matthew.
Whose feast day was January 25th.
He said, I'm not showing you anything. I'm going to show you now.
Go ahead. Verse 24.
What color is these words written in?
Red.
If it's written in red, do you know what it means? I mean, it's a simple question. We don't have to be here all day. it's, you know what it means. I don't know, everybody doesn't know what that means. You know what it means if it's written in red?
It's supposed to mean it's the words of Christ. That's the Messiah.
Exactly,
who saves all people who believe in him.
That's exactly what it means. It means that Christ is speaking.
Which includes
so
Gentiles.
Let's read what Christ said. We don't have to talk about this. Let's just Christ, let's let Christ explain to us. Go ahead.
But he answered and said, I am not sent.
I am not what?
Sent.
I am not what?
Sent.
The Lord, the Most High said, I'm going to send my son to die for the world. Right? I'm going to send my son. I am not sent. Right? He's sending his son to die for the world. Right? But Christ is verifying you what the world that he came to die for is. He said, I am not sent. Go ahead.
But.
What?
Go ahead. Unto the lost sheep of the house of Israel.
There you go. That's it right there, man. I mean, it's that's Christ speaking. You don't have to battle me. I'm only teaching what Christ taught, the same thing that Paul did. Paul taught what Christ taught, the world that Christ, that Paul was going to save, or the Gentiles that Paul was going to save, was those Israelites who were scattered abroad. Go ahead and read.
Matthew chapter 10, verse 5.
Uh-huh.
These 12 Jesus sent forth and commanded them, saying, go not into the way of the Gentiles.
Don't go into the Gentiles.
Why did Christ say, go baptize ye all nations?
Because these people that he called Gentiles were Israelites that were scattered amongst all the nations of the earth.
No. Not what Gentiles. Go baptize ye all nations.
Right. Because
that
these
mean Gentiles.
Because you don't understand the Bible.
Just
the reason you don't understand Gentile, you don't understand nations.
I understand.
So when
he
says go to the Gentiles, he's talking about the scattered Israelites that are following after the traditions of other men.
Who are those?
Those are the. I just said it to you just
the
now.
Are they the 10 tribes or the 12?
Yeah. The 12 tribes of Israel. The 12 tribes of Israel. Give me the New Covenant when it says Hebrews and Hebrews. Finish what you got. This is what Christ told to his apostles. Go ahead and read.
Formed in 1969, he said.
It says, these 12 Jesus sent forth and commanded them, saying, go not into the way of the Gentiles.
Don't go into the way of the Gentiles.
Don't worship them the way of the Gentiles.
Don't go into the way of the Gentiles.
That doesn't mean don't go.
And into any city of the Samaritans enter ye not.
Because Christ said, where these people are, that's not where my people are to be saved from. Go ahead.
But go rather to the lost sheep of the house of Israel.
To the lost sheep of the house of Israel. We were scattered abroad. We were scattered. We were lost. We were amongst other nations. So we were not the Gentiles that you're talking about.
What was the first place?
We were the Gentiles. What does it say?
What was the first place?
What was the first place? What do you mean?
Where's your workplace?
Where?
Or this is our workplace. This is what the priests work here. The priests come to the byways, and they teach the word
celibate?
Of God.
Are you celibate?
Why can this be our job?
Are you celibate?
Why can that this not be our job?
Are you celibate?
Absolutely, I'm a priest.
Are you celibate?
I am a priest.
Are you celibate?
What is it being celibate?
Do you practice celibacy? Does the scripture tell you to practice celibacy?
What scripture are you?
What do you do for a living?
What scripture are you?
Where do you work? You're racist.
Y'all
are racist.
No, what's racist is 400 years of slavery.
I agree, bro.
The Trail of Tears.
I agree.
What's racist is the government that wounded me.
What's racist is
the government of America that police force murdering blacks.
Amen.
That's what
justice
racist
for Tyree
is. So you know what? You're here to teach us about love. Well, you need to go teach the police about love. You need to teach white society about love. You need to teach your people about love. Because you
I
are
got
the
no
real
desire
on the
to
earth.
Teach nobody nothing.
I know, but you want to teach us about love.
You're a priest.
Why don't you go to your church tomorrow
you
and teach your pastor?
Living, sir?
Is
you,
your pastor
your
celibate?
Where do you
is your pastor celibate?
I don't know what this guy's doing, but...
I don't attend a church.
I know you don't attend a church. Because
you?
You're a Satanist, is what you are.
What does that matter?
Why are you asking who they are if you don't know who you are?
I know who I am. They're racist.
What does that mean?
They hate the Jews, they hate white people.
They're saying that they are Jews.
Yeah, well, they're wrong. You know that.
See, I don't know anything.
Well, see, this is...
Okay.
Hey, let me tell you something. White people are ignorant. And this proves that how ignorant they really are. They come over here and they show their ignorance by their behavior. You're supposed to be the top
class of society.
Why don't you show us how to be?
You gotta speak with your chest, man. Speak with your chest.
Why don't you show us how to be class?
Preach. Learn to preach.
But let me tell you something. The reason you can't do it because you're a
so-called white man.
That's why the Lord calls you beast of the field.
Right.
That's why the Lord calls you the beast of the field. Because you don't have any laws. You don't have any rules. You don't have anything that govern you.
Right.
That's probably your wife you're walking up the street. You do things disgusting to that dog, I bet you.
Right.
You know why?
Every Saturday when I walk past y'all from now, I'm going to fuck with y'all. Every Saturday.
That's what you are. But guess what? You're mad at us because we're telling black people to get off drugs. How is that racism?
Right!
You're mad because we call the white man the devil?
You said, right. Hey, you
what
said,
makes us racist?
You said, did you
answer
say,
my let question. Me ask you a question. What makes us racist?
You said, that you're that's racist, that you're anti-Semitism, you're racist.
What, how can we be anti-Jew when we're the Jews?
Right!
You're not
please tell me what's anti-Semitic about us.
Right!
You're a Jew.
Yes, I'm
you're
a Jew.
Jew.
Yes. The real Jews
are
black.
Are you transracial?
See, you don't understand. You don't. You're so ignorant.
Yeah.
You don't even understand the facts that we're laying out.
Say I'm the
we're
Jew
out here.
Again.
We're
I'm
out here
Jewish.
Telling you
Jewish,
who the real Jews are,
yeah.
And you're talking about trans. What is it? Transracial?
That's you, bro.
Yeah, hey. Man. You're ignorant.
Hey,
what's
you
up,
said
man? You
no
got a question?
School shooters have been
you
black.
Said you,
didn't
you, got
you
a question?
Say no school shooters have been
go
black?
Ahead. You said you got a question.
Hey, you
yeah,
said that right?
Yeah.
What I was going to ask him earlier is that if you guys believe in Christ,
right.
The Messiah, Jesus,
yes.
And he says, go out and teach ye all nations and baptize them
in the name of the
Father, and the Son, and the Holy Ghost. All nations is not restricting to Jew or Gentile. It is literally all nations
who are
spawned from... We are all descendants of Noah.
Mm-hmm.
So, my question is that... If you think, well, what he had said earlier, that Christ only came to save Jews.
That's right.
Not, well, I guess Israelites,
right.
I guess.
The lost sheep with the house of Israel.
Okay, now this is getting into a couple of different things. So, if Christ said go out and teach all nations and baptize.
Right.
How is it restrictive to only Israelites?
So let me help you understand.
No. I know what I believe. I'm
I got
asking,
you.
I'm
let me help you understand the Bible in the correct context.
No. Tell me what you believe.
I'm going to tell you what the Bible says. That's what I'm going to tell you. All right?
I don't trust
so you believe that. You believe that when you hear Gentiles can be saved, that it's for all people.
No. I hear go teach and baptize all
right, let me show you what the Bible says. Read that.
Ezekiel chapter 36, verse 24. For I will take you from among the heathen.
I will do what?
Take you from among the heathen.
Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indians have been scattered amongst the heathen because our people, there
because
were some
of sin?
Can you allow me to finish?
Because of sin.
Can you have some decorum?
Because of
Yes, because of sin and transgression and by following the ways of the heathen. So you know what we did? We start to follow your pagan gods and your idols and all of the evil things that you did, which made us be called Gentiles. And so, you know what? We wasn't circumcised on the 8th day. We missed Passover. We started eating pork. So we were called Gentiles. Now, this is the prophecy. And what he said, what? Read it again.
Verse 24. For I will take you from among the heathen.
I'm going to take you from among the heathen.
So
go ahead.
And gather you out of all countries.
Out of where?
All countries.
Gather you from where?
All countries.
Go ahead.
And will bring you into your own land.
That's why I said go into all nations, because we were scattered across the four corners of the earth. So Christ died and sent out men to gather us from all countries. Now,
I feel
I'm going
like
to show
you're
you.
Missing the point.
Yeah, no, I feel like you're missing the point
because
you're trying to hold on to your agenda of being saved, but salvation is not for you.
So why
do you know what salvation for you is?
So why?
Allow me to introduce myself. My name is Yatazat.
So why
listen,
did Paul
listen
go
to
the
what
Apropolis
I'm saying. You're not listening.
I'm listening.
Let me
you
finish.
You don't make any sense.
I'm making the Bible's not making sense to you.
No, you're
I'm not saying anything but what the Bible says.
Your exegesis.
Oh my God,
sense.
Keep reading.
Verse 25.
Don't blaspheme in
front
of me.
So this is what you're missing. We are scattered across the four corners of the earth.
I knew that.
Okay. So when we were scattered across the four corners of the earth, what were we called? Were we still called Jews?
You are Israel.
No, we're when we were in those lands scattered abroad, when we was in Pontus and Cappadocia, and give me 1 Peter 1 and 1. Oh. What were we called then? You don't know. Just say it. It's fine. Give me James 1 and 1.
No.
I'm going to just show you what the Bible says so we won't have to argue. Read what you got. Here we go.
1 Peter chapter 1, verse 1. Mm-hmm. Peter, an apostle of Jesus Christ.
Yep.
To the strangers scattered throughout Pontus.
So, go ahead.
Galatia.
Uh-huh.
Cappadocia.
Uh-huh.
Asia. And Bithynia.
You know why we were called strangers? We were also called Gentiles because we were in these lands following other gods. That's why in Galatians and Ephesians it said, in past times you were called Gentiles. Because we were raised following these other ways, and we thought we never had a way back to the commonwealth of Israel. But Christ died, which gave us an opportunity to come back to our nation.
Right.
Back to the commonwealth of our nation. Read that.
Right.
I'm not disputing
this is the book of James.
I'm not disputing the promise.
Chapter 1, verse 1.
Read.
James, a servant of God,
uh-huh,
and of the Lord Jesus Christ,
uh-huh,
to the 12 tribes.
To all the people in the world.
The 12 tribes.
To everybody on the planet.
The 12 tribes.
Yeah, this is the book of James. This is way after Christ's death. You know what that means? That means the apostles of Christ taught to the 12 tribes which were scattered abroad.
So nobody other than the Israelites.
That was the whole.
Is your claim that no one other than.
I am hearing what you got to say.
So,
go ahead.
So your claim. Your claim.
No, the Bible claim.
No. Your claim. Is that no person other than Israelites can be saved.
Yes, that is not my claim. Because you will be saved. You can be saved if you decide to follow the men of God and the word and Christ. Give me Isaiah 60.
Christ, that's what I'm talking about.
I'm gonna show you something. I'm gonna show you how you're gonna be saved. I know, but you don't understand. You don't understand how you're gonna be saved.
I do understand.
All right, I'm gonna show you Isaiah 60, and give me verse.
So, what kind of Israelite are you?
Start at verse 10.
Are you a Sakari?
No, I'm not. We are the real priests and prophets of God.
So
read what you got.
How come you're different than them?
Read what you got.
Isaiah chapter 60, verse 10.
Uh-huh.
And the sons of strangers shall build up thy walls.
You most definitely will be saved. And because the sons of strangers have to build up our walls.
Right.
Keep reading. So
and their kings shall minister unto thee.
And your kings are going to minister. Not, you ain't going to have a Bible. You're going to serve us.
Right.
That's what real ministry is. Servitude.
Okay.
Keep going.
For in my wrath I smote thee.
Because in the Lord's wrath he smote us. Go ahead.
But in my favor have I had mercy on thee.
Right, but in his favor he's going to have mercy on us. Keep reading.
Verse 11. Therefore thy gates shall be open continually.
Uh-huh. Give me verse 12.
Hold on, cut.
This is straight for you right here. Go ahead.
Isaiah chapter 60, verse 12.
Uh-huh.
For the nation and kingdom.
Hold on, you're not paying attention. You asked me a question.
I'm not.
You asked me a question.
You're not teaching me anything.
I'm giving you the scripture.
You're not teaching me anything.
I'm reading. I'm giving you the scripture.
You're not teaching me anything.
Are you a police officer?
I can listen to you.
Wait. Why? You acting like one. You acting like a police officer that'll hate your own brother. Because you know what? We come out here to give you the truth. We don't even care about him.
I feel like we're all brothers of Christ, though.
But you that's feel like it, but God doesn't say that.
We're all brothers of Christ.
Says who?
Jesus himself.
No, he didn't say that. We're reading what Christ said.
Right.
Show me in the Bible where it said we're all his children. Show me that. Show me. But prove it. You don't got the Bible? But we do. And we're showing you in the Bible where it doesn't say that.
God would never leave you.
So what if I told, what if I showed you in the Bible what God calls him to speak? Okay, if he did, would you fuck? All right, give me Isaiah 40. I'm going to show it to you. Isaiah 40 and 15. I'm going to show you.
Okay.
That's it. I'm not going to argue with you. I'm going to just let the scripture say it. All right. Read that again.
Isaiah chapter 60, verse 12.
Uh-huh.
For the nation and kingdom that will not serve thee.
For the nation and kingdom that won't serve us.
Right.
Under our king.
Right.
What's going to happen?
Shall perish.
Shall what?
Shall perish.
See,
that's
the
right.
Jesus you learn about in the church is not the Jesus in the Bible.
Right.
When Christ comes back, he's coming back to bring war to this earth.
Right.
He's not coming back to bring peace. Christ said, I come not to send peace on earth, but a sword.
That's right.
That's
God
right.
already died for our sins. So when he comes back, He's coming back to take over the world.
Right.
That's what he's coming to do. So, us being his children, we are going to be the kings and the priests under him.
There's no such thing as peace.
So, the people that what? Read it again.
For the nation and kingdom that will not serve thee.
The nation and the kingdom that won't serve us, read.
Shall perish.
Shall what?
Shall perish.
This is what the Bible says. Read.
Yea, those nations shall be utterly wasted.
Those what?
Nations shall be utterly wasted.
Now, you know what nations mean?
Yes.
What does it mean?
Nations, what?
No, what does it mean?
No. Heaven is not.
No, you can't define the word. You can't define nations. Yeah, it means nations.
What does
nation
mean to you?
Nationality.
What does it mean?
The nationality.
Of what?
The other
of
people. Okay. The other races.
What does that have to do with?
What does it say? Those nations shall what?
Those nations shall be utterly wasted.
Utterly what?
Utterly wasted.
What does it mean to be wasted?
Exactly.
What does it mean to be wasted?
The words that you're
I'm asking you a question. This is simple. What does it mean to be wasted?
To die.
Thank you. Well, the people that don't serve Christ and worship the men that Christ put in charge, meaning abide by their authority.
Of course.
Right.
Above.
That means there's going to be
but
a high.
Listen. Us,
damn,
that's
look
us.
At my brother.
That's not us, though.
How is it? Who is it then?
That's okay. That's people that don't believe in Jesus Christ or the God. Those are people that are worshiping money.
And that's why you got to come and learn from your brothers.
But we are brothers.
You got to learn from your brothers, man.
We are brothers.
Right. You got to learn. That's okay. That's why we're here.
You can't put a
because what he is saying is the nations that don't abide by Christ.
Exactly, we're not
his
there
Christ
though.
Christ's authority.
Are you not abiding Christ? Though?
Yes, we are abiding Christ.
Okay,
because we're teaching you the real Christ.
Right.
Look at that picture. This is not Christ.
Right.
So step on him.
I'm not gonna knock.
Why are you not gonna step on him?
Because I believe in Jesus Christ.
Right, but that's not him
that's
though.
But
that's not
never,
him.
You never seen him, so
Christ
you can say
Christ is a black man.
Right.
Okay. The Bible says he's a black man.
Brother,
so step on the white one.
No, hell no.
Because you believe that's Christ.
No, sir.
This is your God.
How are you gonna tell me I don't believe in it?
Read what you got.
This is the book of Isaiah.
I don't believe in it. I don't believe in it.
Now I'm gonna give you that he called them.
I don't believe in color. I don't believe in
you don't believe in color because
be
you believe Jesus,
Jesus.
You believe
Asian
him
man,
was a fairy tale.
Jesus could be
you don't
an
believe
man,
in Christ
or an Indian.
You believe he was just a story that people tell as a modern day myth. You just believe in something that people say to keep people in order.
No.
Because if do you believe Christ was a real man?
He was a real man.
Well, what man do you know that his race don't matter?
His race don't matter, bro.
What's your nationality? You Mexican.
Yeah, we
so when police get behind you, what do you feel?
I don't give a fuck.
You don't care, huh?
Fuck them.
Oh,
fuck
what about
bro.
The babies at the border?
It sucks, bro. It sucks. It's not our
no, problem. It can't be. So I thought race didn't matter. Where are the East Indian babies?
If you have power,
where
to
are the East Indian babies
care
at the border?
Take care.
You can care less about your people. You see why I asked you at first? I asked you, were you a police officer? You know why? Because there were five police officers yesterday that killed their brother. And they didn't give a damn. Just like you don't give a damn. You'll be perfect. You'll be a perfect police officer. Because you hate your people. I know you would care less. And that's why you're not over here with us. We care more. You care less. That's the difference between us, me and you. Christ, why do you care about a conversation with this devil when I came out here to love you? I don't care. I came out here for you. Why do you want me to listen to him when I would rather have a conversation with you?
You're trying to lecture him.
No, I am. You know why I'm trying to lecture him? Because this is my book. We are the authorities of this book. Yes, it is. This book is directed to our family. This book is directed for our inheritance. Read that. Read 40 and 15. Now, you asked me. No, he asked me. You asked me for a scripture that said that they were spit.
Okay.
All right, read that.
Why does it have to be under
oath?
Read
that.
The nations are as a drop of a bucket.
Hey. You missed it. You're not paying attention, bro. You're not paying attention to the Bible. I'll go back to that. I'll go back to it. Give me a second. Listen to what he said. Listen to God's word. Read.
White man,
the nations are as a drop
of a bucket.
Who is at the top of a bucket?
The nations.
The nations. What did I tell you nations mean? Races, nationalities. God said the nations are as a drop of the bucket. Keep reading.
And are counted as the small dust of the balance.
Do you love dust? Do you have dust that you grab up every day and you hold it and you say, I love you and I'm gonna take care of you every day? No, you wipe dust off. Because dust means nothing to you. Well, right. That's what he means.
The same way the race, the Lord don't give a damn about him. Okay, the same
the
way
the Lord don't care about his people.
Right. The same way race means nothing.
But not
to
only
me.
His people.
Okay, if dust,
but
hold on,
Africans, right. East Indians, okay. Chinese, and Japanese, dust, all these other nations mean nothing to God.
If dust means nothing to you, why does race mean something to you?
Because it means something to you.
No, it don't.
Well,
no,
step
it
on
don't.
It. Step on it.
He's my brother.
Step
He's
on
my
it.
Brother. Step He's my
that.
Brother. You're my brother.
Step on that picture for your brother.
I ain't gonna
You know
step
why? Because that step. Means something to you.
It does.
All right.
I don't see it. It's more
but you
race.
Just said it didn't.
I don't see a race.
You just said it didn't.
I said race don't mean a thing to me.
Well, step
a
on
man.
It.
Deuteronomy chapter 7, verse 6.
Uh-huh.
For thou art an holy people
mm-hmm.
unto the Lord thy God.
Go ahead.
The Lord thy God has chosen thee.
Has done what?
Chosen thee.
If we on the basketball court.
Chosen thee what?
Chosen thee what? Chosen thee what?
To be a special people. Unto
Where's race?
Himself.
Where's race? Where's race?
Here it come.
Where's color at? Where's
above.
Race?
Hold up.
Above
what?
All people.
Above what?
All people.
Where's race,
Where?
Bro? Where's
above
race?
All people.
Exactly. Where? Keep going.
That are upon the face of the earth.
God chose us. Listen. God chose us to be above.
Who's us? Who's us?
The children of Israel.
Who's the children? The children of God.
That,
children
no, of he says the children of Israel.
Right.
That's what this is about.
He didn't say the children of Israel.
These be the words which Moses spake unto all Israel.
All of everybody?
Israel.
Yeah, you hear me? These are the words that Moses spake to us.
Okay.
So everything that we're reading
but,
is directed
okay.
to us.
Okay, wait. But if you're saying Israel, that's where it's coming from, bro. Like, that's where they're at in that time.
No,
that they're making
Israel
the
is.
There's
listen,
no social media
listen,
at that time. They ain't no
listen,
way. Hey, over there in
listen
North America,
to me.
Hey,
listen,
there,
listen to your brother.
I got you.
Listen. Israel is not a place.
It
it's
is
a
place.
People.
Bro.
Listen. It's a people. It's a nation of people. All right? The Israelites are the children of Israel. We are the children of Israel. So what we're teaching our brothers and sisters is that you are not Mexican. That is a name given to you in slavery. I am not African American. That is a name given to me when I was conquered. I am from the tribe of Judah. You are from the tribe of Issachar. We are a conquered nation.
We're not conquered.
Do you know what freedom is? Do you know what real freedom is?
We have freedom right now.
Freedom?
We have freedom right now, bro.
Somebody look up the definition of liberty.
This is the definition of liberty. The state of being free within society from oppressive restrictions.
From what?
From oppressive restrictions.
Stop. We are not free from society. So we are not free.
I know.
All right? So that means we are still oppressed. And we got these. What's the devil? Who? What is the oppressive society that we're under? The government. Stop.
Okay.
Who sits on the top seat of the government?
The devil, the devil.
Give him a hand. What are we arguing about? So, who is the devil that sits on top of those seats? Then let me help you out. According to what we've been taught in religion, that's who the devil is. The angel that fell from heaven. According to the Bible, the white man is the devil. Now, I'm going to show you that. Read.
This is the book of Isaiah.
Read verse 4. 14-4.
Chapter 14, verse 4.
Uh-huh.
That thou shalt take up this proverb against the king of Babylon.
The king of who?
Babylon.
The king of Babylon. Okay? This is who we're talking about. Now read verse 12.
Verse 12. How art thou fallen from heaven, O Lucifer?
Who is Lucifer according to the Bible? We just said, who is this? No. Read verse 4 again.
That thou shalt take up this proverb against the king of Babylon.
Who is this talking about? Read and say it again.
That thou shalt take up this proverb against the king of Babylon.
Who is this talking about? The king of Babylon. Now, let's find out who the king of Babylon is. Read verse 12.
How are thou fallen from heaven, O Lucifer?
Oh, who?
Lucifer.
Guess what? Guess who Lucifer is? The king of Babylon. Read verse 16.
Verse 16. They that see thee shall narrowly look upon thee and consider thee, saying, is this the man?
Is this the spirit?
That made
no, read that again. Is this the what?
Is this the man?
Is this the demon?
Is this the man?
Is this the man with the horn and the pitchfork under the ground?
Is this the man?
Do you know who the devil is?
I do.
ISUPK presents the 54th annual Feast of Unleavened Bread. Last year we did it big. This year is gonna be way big. More brotherhood, more sisterhood, more UPK. On Sunday, April 2nd, 2023, we're gonna be at 421 South Salisbury Street in Raleigh, North Carolina, at the Sheraton Raleigh Hotel Bar. We're calling all blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indians to come join us. Into your third eye peephole, line for line, this shit too easy. It's like a free throw. Mastered the game too early. This bitch. Remember, admission to the Passover is $200 per adult. That's $200 per adult. For more information, call 919-697-8257. Call 919-697-8257.